We'll see if she does that here at the start of this women's singles round of 32 match. She does, she tests the waters there. Samara's going to have to be quite aggressive early on because we know Yang Shaoxin can change the pace with the pimples, the pips. Opens up the wrist there to play the backhand on the parallel. Good start for Monaco's Lone Ranger. Pinning the backhand 3 out of 3 times. The short side of the table as a right hander and left hander, the parallel. Yet a point to be scored for Elisabetta Samara. Phenomenal start from the woman on screen. Tight backspin serve to the forehand that time. Rhythm breaking. Unpredictability serves paramount in table tennis. It's the only shot in the game that you have 100% control. And there we go. Chole for Samara and the first point on the board. Every 6 points you can go over to the towel box. Nice forehand fade. That's the Samara speciality. My producer tells me she was saying she feels quite jet-lagged, but no excuses out here. It's a sport which teaches a lot of accountability. There's only yourself to blame if you lose.
6-2.
To Yang Shaoxin. Flips the net there. Samara going for heavy spin. Part of this Romanian women's team, Samara. She's kind of the captainess, spearheading that team. You can see how the pips can have the disturbing effect. The first one that comes is often no spin. So you don't want to brush up the back of it too much. You can come through it if it's long enough to attack.
2-9.
Yet to get into her stride, Samara. She trails 2-9. A rabbit in the headlights right now. 8 game points, shutout. It can be daunting for these players because I doubt they would have played in front of any more people than they are now.
10-3.
It's only day one and it's already packed out. Xingshan really is the new hometown of table tennis. And there we have it, 11-3, goodness me. Yeah. To play with a little bit more heart here in game two.
Love one.
Just looking at the draw, the winner of this match will play either Sun Ying Sha, who sits pretty at the top of the draw, who's playing against Du Hoi Kem of Team Hong Kong, China. But there's no easy route to the final here. It's the world's best 32 here in Xingshan. Oh, the parallel forehand. Gorgeous timing there. 14 of the last 17 points have gone to Yang Shaoxin. It's more like it from Samara there. Better body language, just bouncing on the toes, keep the blood flowing. Keep the toes showing and the forehands going. Opens up the body nicely there.
three.
Samara has an unbelievable amount of European Championship medals, 23. I said 21, 5 of which are bronze, 8 of which are silver, and 8 of which are gold. Won the singles in 2015, won the doubles twice, mixed doubles twice, and the women's team 3 times, most recently in 2019. Some player, Samara, and very well respected across the world.
3, 4.
Good run of points here. See the service success here of Yang Xiaoxin. The hook serve, and it catches
five,
the edge.
Three.
No point cheating in front of a crowd this big, because everyone knows if it hits the edge. You might have seen on the WTT social media pages the poll as to whether you thought it was an edge or a side. Sometimes that can be difficult to tell, but when it comes
three.
Off the back of the table, more obvious. A kill streak here for Samara, 6-3 in the lead with a serve to come. Nice fade, and then over the top of the ball, she's playing aggressively. Smooth, like silk, over the table. Got nice hand skills. A bit more flair to her game than Yang Xiaoxin, Samara.
Left, 3-7.
A bit more route one, player from Monaco. And Samara survives. Gets away with the long push. Good hands, soft hands just to caress the ball with the block there, and it was deep enough to trouble her opponent, who isn't the tallest of players. It's hard to pinpoint the short player's crossover, but you can get them out wide.
9-3.
Was she 3-1 down in this game? Is this 8 in a row for Samara? Can't quite remember, but... Oh, there we go, yeah. 8 of the last 8. 100% record. Well, that's a nice recovery, isn't it? Yang Xiaoxin has been as high as 10 in the world. Clips the edge there. Her best win, Kasumi Ishikawa. She beat 4-1 back in 2019. She's also beaten the likes of Ni Xialian and Han Ying around that time period. Well, some relief for Samara after a really poor game one that she can showcase her class here. She has 5 game points as a reward. Oh my goodness, how on earth has she played that line? It's quite evident that Samara has the flair to counteract Yang Xiaoxin's varying equipment. She's gauging the percentages better on the receive, Samara. She's not going for anything too big, nor too passive. Just rolling it back, and then she gets in with the bigger attacks afterwards. Here she comes again. Pendulum serve. Stunning combination. She pushes long and then gets the bat high ready to counteract. Because at this level, you know if you push the ball long, you're going to get an attack back. Playing with the next shot in mind, Yang Xiaoxin. It's a nice angle there on the backhand, a nice closed racket, early timing point and low posture. Straight out the table tennis textbook. 1-2. Ooh, just got away there. Looked like it might have been Yang's point. Wasn't. She has the ability to, Samara, to get those extra balls back. Good away from the table, I'd say she's in her prime when she's about mid-distance, whereas Yang Xiaoxin's a bit more of a table hugger. Oh, it was a lovely little dink, but just couldn't put the icing on the cake. She fans her face and exhales deeply just to relax herself. Breathing is so important in a sport, well, in life, but especially in a sport with such fine margins. You've got to be very relaxed in table tennis.
3-4.
Represented Monaco internationally since 2014. Clips the net.
3-4.
Just disturbed Samara's ability to read that trajectory. So much topspin on it. Two nets in that point. Apologises. And then another.
5-3.
Things just aren't going Samara's way here. The luck tends to even itself out across the course of a match. Especially a tough pill to swallow because Samara had the two serves there. Best rally of the match. Samara just looked in two minds there, a little bit tentative playing the backhands. And she's playing against a variety of different spins. Doubling the points of her opponent. Yang Xiaoxin, 6-3 in the lead. Misses the serve. There's a origami, as Adam likes to call it, a souvenir, a gift. 4-6, Samara serving for survival. That's a good receive. Right on the white line, painting the table. Oh, and another net. Well, the table tennis gods are blessing Yang Xiaoxin right now. Samara's wondering what on earth she did to deserve this kind of karma.
9-4.
It's the exact same service motion as the tight one, the short serve that she does, but that time she just goes long and quick, floaty. Difficult to do much against flow.
4-10.
Blink your eyes and all of a sudden, 6 game points to Yang Xiaoxin. Coming back, and again. Oh, a nice finish there for Yang Xiaoxin. The crowd appreciating the lob and smash exhibition style rally.
3-1 love.
Yang Xiaoxin can't afford to think about the finish line. She has to be present here. Oh, a nice finish.
1-4.
She just turns, she pivots in an instant, doesn't she, Yang Xiaoxin? Look at this, how quick she was just to make that compound movement. She'll favour the forehand in those positions all day long. Goes for a heaving topspin. That exaggerated movement just... A little bit leaning back there. You can't afford to lean too far back. Otherwise you lose your balance and technique.
Let 2-1.
Kind of want to be hunched over the ball in a way. 2-1. Oh, it's another dribbler. I feel for Samara here, I must say. She looks over to her coach as though to say, what the heck can I do? 12 of the last 16. To Yang Xiaoxin, but now Samara fighting back. Strong players from Romania, Bernadette Such, Diaconu, just to name a couple. Samara there, exploding into that like a coiled spring. So much potential energy, and she reaches her potential in that shot there. High class backhand, cross court. Making things a little bit more interesting. Having a few problems with the serve, and that's the beauty of the shovel, the hook serve. You're coming around the side of it, so the contact point is a little bit more discreet. Goes for the flick. We haven't seen a flick too many, Samara, with that kind of intensity. Better to miss the right way than the wrong way, as obvious as that sounds. So she might try and build on that. She calls the timeout though, slipping through her fingers here. Well, she's got a 19% win record against top 20 players, Samara, which is solid. Shows that she's a world-class player, but this top 20 player is just a little bit too hot to handle right now. Yang Xiaoxin coming in with the shovel serve again. Oh, that is breathtaking from Samara. Sorry, not sorry, because the luck hasn't evened itself out. I wonder what she apologised there for. Oh, the edge. Okay. Quite a thick edge, though.
4-8.
She's so hungry for this, Samara. Recently been appointed to the Athletes Commission of WTT. Oh, that time the net doesn't trouble her. Gave her a little bit more time on the ball, actually. And she plays the fade. Called the fade because it fades away due to the side spin, the open face of the racket angle. Oh, she did well there, Yang Xiaoxin, because Samara greased that topspin. Just wasn't in quite a good enough position to cause a big enough problem. And she's 2 points away from exiting this competition. Two away from victory, Yang Xiaoxin.
Nine six.
You got a player to the ref's whistle, to the umpire's call. I don't think either player there actually noticed the net. Well, this has been some performance. She's beaten 34 of her 48 left-handed opponents, which is an incredible start again for a right-hander against a left-hander. She has 4 match points, Yang Xiaoxin. Oh, and well, that tells some of the story, doesn't it? Ending in the net there. But a great match from Yang Xiaoxin. The tactics were on point and she executed very well.